What dost thou wish? If it must be, I will sell my last jewel so that an attentive slave may wait upon the desire of thine eyes and every thirst of thy lips. If the milk of our goat seems insipid to thee, I will hire, as for an infant, a nurse with swollen breasts who will suckle thee each morning. If our bed seems rough, I will buy thee all the soft cushions, all the coverlets of silk, all the cloths soft with feathers of the Amethysian merchants. Oh. But I should suffice thee, and though we sleep upon the earth, thou shouldst find it softer than the warm bed of a stranger. Great eyes of Nesadika, how happy you make me when love darkens your lids and quickens you and shadows you with tears. But how maddened when you turn elsewhere, distracted by a woman who passes or by a remembrance which is not mine. Great eyes of Nesadika, cease not to reward me, or I will stab you with my needle, and then you will see only the terrible night. I have given her a doll of wax with cheeks of roses. In the evening, she cradles it and gives it a breast before putting it to sleep. She has woven it three little tunics, and we gave it jewels on the day of the Aphrodisian festival. But more than her balls or her doll, I am for her a game. With all parts of my body, she amuses herself through the long hours without speaking. She loosens my hair and reforms it according to her caprice, knotting it into my chin like a thick cloth, twisting it upon the nape of my neck, or braiding it to the end. She sees with astonishment the color of my lashes, the folds of my neck. Sometimes she makes me kneel and place my hands on the bed. Then, it is one of her games, she slips her little head underneath and imitates the trembling kid which sucks from the belly of its mother. She has gone out and is far away, but I see her. For all things in this chamber are full of her. All are related to her, I like the rest. This bed, still warm, over which I pass my mouth, is impressed with the form of her body. On this soft pillow, this lane, her little head enveloped in her hair. There is the basin in which she bathed, the comb which penetrated the knots of her tangled hair. These slippers long for her naked feet. The pockets of gauze enclosed her breasts. But that which I dare not touch with my finger is the mirror in which she viewed her hot bruises, and in which perhaps still exists the reflection of her moist lips. I think of her, my throat becomes dry, my head droops, my breasts grow hard and pain me. I shiver and weep as I walk. When I see her, my heart stops, my hands tremble, my feet grow cold. A crimson of fire mounts to my cheeks. My temples throb grievously. When I touch her, I become mad. My arms weaken, my knees swoon. I fall before her and lie like a woman about to die. The sun has passed all the night among the dead while I have waited, seated upon my bed, weary from watching. A wick of the exhausted lamp has burned to the end. She will never return. There is the last star. I know well that she will never return. I know even the name that I hate. Nevertheless, I still still wait. That she would come now. Yes, that she would come, her hair disordered and without roses, her robe soiled, spotted, rumpled, her tongue dry and her eyelids black. When she opened the door, I would say to her, but here she is. It is her robe that I touch. Her hands, her hair, her skin. I kiss her with distracted lips. And I weep. For whom now shall I paint my lips? For whom shall I polish my nails? For whom shall I perfume my hair? For whom are my breasts powdered with rouge? They no longer tempt her. For whom are my arms laved with milk if they may nevermore embrace her? How can I sleep? How can I lay myself upon the bed? In the evening, my hand in all my bed could not find her warm hand. I dare not return to my house, to the chamber so frightfully empty. I dare not reopen the door. I dare not even reopen mine eyes. I remember. Of what hour of the day is it not before my eyes? I remember the manner in which she lifted her hair with her slender fingers so. I remember one night when she passed her cheek upon my breast, so softly that happiness held me awake. And the day following, she had upon her face the mark of my rounded nipple. I see her holding her cup of milk and regarding me sideways with a smile. I see her powdered, her hair dressed, opening her great eyes before her mirror and retouching with her finger the red of her lips. And above all, if my despair is a perpetual torture, it is because I know moment by moment how she swoons in the arms of another, and what she demands of her, and what she gives. If life is a long dream, what good to resist? Now, 4 and 5 times a night, I demand amorous enjoyment, and when my loins are exhausted, I sink asleep wherever my body falls. In the morning, I open my eyelids and I shiver in my hair. A dove is upon my window. I ask of her, in what month are we? She says to me, it is the month when women are in love. Whatever be the month, the dove speaks truly. And I throw my 2 arms about my lover, and with great tremblings, I stretch my still benumbed legs to the foot of the bed. The night has worn away. The stars are distant. The last courtesans have returned with their lovers, and I, in the rain of morning, write this, my last verse, upon the sand. Rest upon the bed, my body, according to thy voluptuous mission. Taste thy daily enjoyments and the passions without a tomorrow. Leave not a joy unknown to be regretted upon the day of thy death. Aphrodite, merciless goddess, thou hast willed it. Thy procession comes to carry me in triumph to thee, all naked upon a shell-like car, upon which slaves have placed 10,000 roses. I recline thereon, my hands under my neck, my feet alone clad in gold. and my body outstretched softly upon the bed of my warm hair mingling with the cool petals. 12 children with winged shoulders served me to the goddess. One of them holds a shade. The others shower me with perfume or burn incense in the prow. About me I hear rustling the ardent murmur of a multitude, while the breath of desire floats about my nudity, reaching to the blue mist of the aromatics. Aphrodite, here is Belitis.